Hello children, good morning. In today's class we are going to see about a very beautiful story and we will be solving some more problems. C93, an old woman's will. Once there lived an old woman. She lived with her three daughters. She was quite rich and had 19 camels. How many daughters did she have? She had three daughters and she had 19 camels. Okay. One day she fell ill. She was not feeling well. The daughters called the doctor. The doctor tried his best but could not save the woman. After her death, the daughters read what she had written in her will. So before dying, she has written something for her daughters. So what did she write? Look here, my eldest daughter will get 1/2 of my camels. My second daughter will get 1/4 of my camels. My third daughter will get 1/5 of my camels. So the daughters were really surprised and puzzled. How can I get half of 19 camels? The lady had 19 camels, said, so what is half of 19? It is, half of 19 is 9.5, but we can't cut the camel. So we cannot make a half camel, right? The second daughter was much puzzled. That is right, but what to do? So the third daughter is asking. Then by the time their aunt is coming and she is telling a way to solve their problem. Show me the will. I have an idea. You take my camel, so you have 20 camels. Now you can divide them as your mother wanted. And the aunt said. So now they had 20 camels. So what is half of 20 camels? That is 10 camels, okay? So the eldest daughter took 10 camels. Take your share, the aunt told to the second daughter. She took 1/4 of the camels and got how many camels? What is 1/4 of 20? That is same as 20 divided by 4. And that is nothing but 5. Is it clear? 4 5s are 20, right? So she will get 5 camels, okay? And you can take 1/5 of the camels, the aunt told to the third daughter. So what is 1/5 of 20? Just find it out. It is nothing but 20 divided by 5. And 5 4s are 20, so the answer is 4. So she got 4 camels, right? The daughter was very happy. And they counted the camels. The first daughter got 10 camels, second daughter got 5 camels, and third daughter got 4 camels. So totally 19 camels. And one camel was left out, and the one remaining is mine, the aunt said, and she took the camel away. Okay, how did this happen? Actually, this calculation is mathematically wrong, but if she did not give that one more camel, then the daughters would not have their shares according to the mother's will. Okay. So this is how they divided the camels among each of them. This will be your next question. C94. We sleep for 8 hours in a day. What part of a day is it? Okay. So we all sleep for 8 hours in a day, right? And we have to find what part of 24 hours is that. Okay. So write the solution. Total hours in a day equal to 24. Hours we sleep equal to 8. Okay. So you will write next one. Part of a day we sleep equal to 8 divided by 24. That is part that we sleep divided by whole of the day. Is it clear? Next one is, you can cancel 8 and 24 in 8 table itself. 8 ones are 8 and 8 threes are 24. So the final answer is 1/3. So we sleep for 1/3 of a day, right? Coming to the next question. What part of a leap year do we sleep? Okay, you all know what is a leap year, right? A leap year has 366 days because one more day will be added in February, that is 29th of February month. Okay. So coming to the answer, number of days in a leap year equal to 366. Okay. So we know that for one day we are sleeping 1/3 part, right? So for 366 days, we have to multiply this 1/3 with 366.
Okay, so you will write part of a leap year. We sleep equal to 1/3 of 366. So if we sleep for 1/3 of a day, then for 366 it is 1/3 of 366. Okay, so that is nothing but you just have to multiply 1 and 366, that is 366 as it is, and divided by 3. And you can cancel 366 and 3. 3 ones are 3, and here also 3 ones are 3. 3 twos are 6, again 3 twos are 6. So what is remaining? 122. So it is nothing but 122 days. Is it clear? So we sleep for 122 days in a leap year.